From the Home Slice News Center, this is the Daily Slice for Monday, January 30th, 2023. I'm D. Ray Knight. This is what's going on. State Senator Julie Frye-Mueller made a public statement Saturday in response to her suspension from the South Dakota Senate. Frye-Mueller, who represents District 30 in the State Senate, was pulled from her committee assignments after an exchange with a female legislative staff member. A day later, the Senate voted to indefinitely suspend Frye-Mueller pending an investigation into the exchange the senator had with a Legislative Research Council staffer. Frye-Mueller says the conversation touched on intimate and personal details regarding maternal issues between two women and discussion on vaccines. The committee will decide on Frye-Mueller's potential expulsion this week. Work will begin today on the downtown parking garage renovations. Amy Rose has the details.
Phase one of renovations to the Rapid City downtown parking garage are set to begin today. During this project, both staircases will be renovated and include a partial enclosure of the stairs to protect the structure and the people who use it. The original structure is about 25 years old, and some of the steel has begun to corrode. The corrosion of the steel is happening at a faster pace than usual because of the salt that is used to treat the roads and sidewalks during the winter.
Helping with Horsepower and the Sturgis Rally Endowment will split $25,000, the proceeds of the sale of a rebuilt motorcycle sold at auction Saturday. Laura Clock, founder and president of Helping with Horsepower, along with Mitchell Technical College's Power Sports program, customized the 2018 Harley-Davidson Road Glide for the 2023 Mecham Las Vegas auction. In national and international news, House Speaker Kevin McCarthy says he's looking forward to discussing with President Joe Biden a reasonable and responsible way that we can lift the debt ceiling when the two meet Wednesday at the White House. It'll be their first sit-down since McCarthy became Speaker. McCarthy tells CBS's Face the Nation that he wants to address spending cuts along with raising the debt limit, but the White House has ruled out pairing those two together as the government tries to avoid a potentially devastating financial default. The Speaker is pledging that cuts to Social Security and Medicare will be off the table. Amy Rose has the latest on the war in Ukraine.
Russian shelling killed at least 5 people and wounded 13 others as the Kremlin's and Kyiv's forces remained locked in combat in eastern Ukraine. The casualties reportedly included a woman who was killed and 3 others who were wounded by the Russian shelling of Kharkiv, Ukraine's second largest city in the country's northeast. Moscow's troops seized large areas of the northeastern Kharkiv region in the months following its invasion of its neighbor last February. But Ukrainian counteroffensives that began in August snatched back most of the Russian-occupied territory.
Patrick Mahomes finally got the best of Joe Burrow. All he needed was a little shove. Harrison Butker made a 45-yard field goal with 3 seconds left after Cincinnati's Joseph Asai was flagged for a 15-yard penalty for shoving Mahomes after he was out of bounds, and the Chiefs beat the Bengals 23-20 in the AFC Championship game. Kansas City will face the Philadelphia Eagles in the Super Bowl on February 12th in Glendale, Arizona. The Eagles clobbered the Niners 31-7 in the NFC title game earlier on Sunday. Your weather forecast from the Home Slice Weather Center. Sunny but very cold with a high of 16. Low tonight, 4. And that was your Daily Slice for Monday, January 30th, 2023. The Daily Slice is a production of Home Slice Media Group, hosted by D. Ray Knight with Amy Rose. Executive producer Mark Houston. Engineered by Chris Jacquez. I'm D. Ray Knight. Have a great day.